Hello everyone, my name is Adrian.
I'm Nick.
And we brought along our friend Andrew from the SimpleLink Wi-Fi team to talk a little bit about 5 gigahertz and dual band. So with the launch of our new Wi-Fi products, we're starting to get a lot of questions from the community, and we wanted to bring some of these to you today. So without further ado, we'll jump in. So the first question is, I guess, very high level. Why should developers care about dual band technology when it comes to Wi-Fi?
And this is a big question, especially in the community. Everybody knows about dual band, but they're really asking, why do I need it, right? So we've all been to a network or a building where we try to connect our smart device to the network, and we're thinking, oh, it's going to be better if I'm on Wi-Fi or so. And as soon as we connect, our performance is low, it's not as increased as we thought. And this is due to the fact that all our networks in the past have been created in this 2.4 gigahertz bandwidth. With dual band, we're able to support the 2.4 and 5 gigahertz spectrums. What this means is we can increase the performance due to the overlay of the networks, and there's not as much congestion since we do have more spectrums and channels to choose from.
Yeah, and correct me if I'm wrong, Andrew, but so Wi-Fi traditionally at 2.4 gigahertz, but Wi-Fi is not the only standard there. So at 2.4, you're dealing with Zigbee, you're dealing with BLE, all these other standards clogging the band.
Correct. So on that band, 2.4 has a lot of different devices, different bandwidths happening in that section, right? So now that we're able to bring this spectrum of 5 gigahertz and choose different channels, it reduces that congestion and able to increase performance in smart devices.
Very cool. And now that we talked a little bit about why 5 gigahertz or dual band is important for Wi-Fi, are there any trade-offs when considering 5 gigahertz?
So in 5 gigahertz, we can see, due to the attenuation, we do see a shorter range in 5 gigahertz compared to the 2.4, but this can also be increased due to the access points, transceiving and receiving powers, as well as some signal chains in order to increase that range, right? As well as we do see in the 5 gigahertz a much harder RF front-end design in the 5 gigahertz compared to the 2.4. The good thing is TI is offering a module that already integrates the PA and LNA functions in order to help our customers implement the dual band much easier.
Okay, very cool. Yeah, that actually leads us into the next question from the community here. You mentioned a module. How does this help developers integrate 5 gigahertz into their application?
That's correct. So in dual band, like I said, it's a much complicated front-end design, but in the new dual band modules that we're in here, they're regulatory certified and come with the radio filters, radio frequency filters, in order to help with an ease of use design and come with a plug-and-play solution for our customers.
Very cool. And the particular devices that we're talking about here, can you reiterate the part numbers for customers?
Yeah, definitely. The new SimpleLink Wi-Fi devices are the CC3135 and 3235 devices.
Okay, and those are available as both, I guess, discrete components as well as the module-based.
Correct.
Okay. Yes. Very cool. Awesome. Next question. Any impact on low power capabilities?
So usually on dual band, with everything considered equally, 5 gigahertz might do a better TX and RX current draw. But since the memory retention is similar in these devices, on our CC3135 and 3235 devices, we don't see a difference in low power. We still offer the lowest power devices with the new dual band.
And this enables battery-operated Wi-Fi products?
Correct.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah, and you mentioned there's some trade-offs there. So for instance, with 5 gigahertz, you may see shorter range, and then you may have to boost the output power to get longer range, which may be more power hungry on the RX TX side.
Correct. It might, but as mentioned before, since the sleep memory retention on these devices are still similar, our devices do not change in low power.
Next question from the community. Are we seeing more products or end applications that require dual band?
Definitely. So as the networks grow and as we increase our users, we do see a higher need for dual band. And one of the biggest examples in medical, in our hospitals, we see that all their devices they want to use the 5 gigahertz network, whereas their guests are usually on the 2.4 gigahertz. This is so in order to the congestion will be reduced and they can have high performance for all their people in the hospital, right?
Awesome. And then the last question, I guess, where can developers get started with 5 gigahertz development?
So in our new SimpleLink Wi-Fi devices, we do offer the dual band 2.4 and 5 gigahertz spectrums, as well as the new loop power modes that will help increase battery life, and not to mention that they are FIPS certified in order to give a higher security process. So what FIPS is the Federal Information Processing Standard. So not only are they getting the dual band 5 gigahertz and 2.4 along with the low power modes, they're also more secure and enhanced in order to give them assurance that they're safe.
Awesome, sounds like great devices.
Yeah, and we actually had Andrew on here for a double session, so you'll learn a little bit about FIPS as well as this 5 gigahertz session to learn what those new SimpleLink Wi-Fi products bring to the table. Cool, well, thanks Andrew, thanks for joining us. This was great to learn more about the dual band and 5 gig and why that's important. I've always had it, like I've started getting it in my home routers, but I didn't know exactly what it meant, so it's helpful.
Definitely, and I think a lot of people, like I said, they understand it because of our routers. Everybody knows, oh, in an end user benefit, it might seem better with everything considered equal. And so everybody wants to have dual band, right? But what's really happening is that overlay of networks is helping their performance increase.
Yeah, it makes sense. Well, thank you. Thanks again for joining us. Thank you guys for joining this episode of Connect. As always, there's going to be a new SimpleLink demo coming out next week. Be sure not to miss that one. And if you want to learn more specifically about 5 gigahertz, we'll link some collateral and some material for you guys to see. If you want to learn more about the SimpleLink platform and these new SimpleLink Wi-Fi devices, go to ti.com/SimpleLink or ti.com/Wi-Fi, and you can find a bunch of material there. Tweet at us, at Sensor2Cloud, let us know feedback, topics you'd like seeing. Thank you guys so much for joining us.
Cool. Thanks.